so I'm kind of feeling a bit of a crisis of identity, and everyone's wondering, who is that lady on the stage? That's where I hang my hat most days, although I'm here with my husband Josh and my 6-week-old baby Greer, so if you guys hear baby crying, I apologize in advance. But it's a wonderful occasion that we're here to celebrate tonight in the city of Regina on Treaty 4 land, and we're delighted that so many of you were able to take the time this evening, now that the election is over and that there is no baseball game currently on, that you can all come down and talk about really important things like women's role in society. So thank you so much for coming. And I'd like to extend a special welcome tonight to tonight's keynote speaker, Sheila Fahlman, who's sitting here in the front row. Maybe you can stand up. You can all give a round of applause. Also, we are honored to have some distinguished guests, many of whom have supported this event since its inception 12 years ago. Here tonight is Honorable Mark Dougherty, Minister of Parks, Culture and Sport, Minister responsible for Provincial Capital Commission, and I hope nothing else because it's a long time ago as it is. Mark, there he is at that. The Honorable Christine Kell, Minister responsible for Corrections and Policing. Ms. Laura Ross, MLA for Regina Capel Valley. Mayor Michael Fugere. Margaret Ann Hodges, President of the Association of Professional Engineers and Geoscientists. And Inspector Lori Warren and Inspector Sherry Ortman with Regina Police. We also are lucky to have with us tonight three past speakers from recent celebrations. Tina Beaudry-Miller. Her Worship, Mayor Deb Higgins, Moose Jaw. And Claire Belanger Parker. Now I'd like to invite Laura Ross, MLA for Regina Capel Valley, to the podium to bring greetings on behalf of the Government of Saskatchewan Status of Women.
Thank you very much, Morgan, and what a wonderful evening tonight. I know that, in fact, I was listening to Deb Higgins say, well, you know, I didn't know if I wanted to drive all the way in, and then she says, I love a nice drive. And I think, I hope each and every one of you had a chance to see that sunset this evening. It was absolutely incredible. The sky was on fire, so, in fact, Deb said she had a chance to drive through that, in with that kind of sunset. So thank you very much for making the drive in from Moose Jaw. But I'm so pleased to join you this evening and bring greetings on behalf of my colleague, the Honorable Donna Harper. Donna is the Minister of Social Services. She's also the Minister responsible for the status of women. I would also like to acknowledge my colleagues from the Legislative Assembly, Christine Tell and Mark Dougherty. Now, this event is a wonderful opportunity to celebrate women's contribution and achievement, not only in Saskatchewan, but beyond its borders. I would like to begin by acknowledging the Women's History Committee and the Association of Professional Engineers and Geoscientists of Saskatchewan for organizing this fine event. We should give them a round of applause. Very fitting that this celebration coincides with Women's History Month, which takes place in October every year. Women's History Month provides all Canadians with an opportunity to recognize and appreciate how women have shaped our country's history. It is also an opportunity to acknowledge the vital contributions women make to strengthening our economy, our communities, and our families. Saskatchewan's theme this year is Breaking Conventional Molds, Saskatchewan Women in Education. It recognizes the innovative models that women in the field of education are creating to ensure our leaders of tomorrow are acquiring the skills and training needed to be successful. Your association is contributing to this vision by ensuring that engineers and geoscientists have the right education, the right skills, the right attitude to enhance the quality of life, health, and safety, and well-being of Saskatchewan citizens. Our government supports this vision wholeheartedly and commends the work that you do each and every day to carry out your mandate. Women's History Month isn't only important to women, but it's important to everyone in this province. For centuries, women have demonstrated determination, commitment, and conviction in their quest for equal opportunity. They have emerged as role models of change towards equality, fairness, and progress. And as a result, everyone benefits. It is in this perseverance and spirit that have shaped our province and in keeping Saskatchewan strong and moving forward. In closing, I would like to thank the Association of Professional Engineers and Geoscientists of Saskatchewan for the work you do throughout the year. You serve your members and carry out your regulatory outreach and development functions. Our government appreciates your dedication and wishes you and your members continued success in your endeavors. Thank you again for the opportunity for being here, and congratulations, Margaret Ann, for being president. Thank you.
Laura, for your remarks and for your support of this event and your service to our community. I'd like to now welcome His Worship, Michael Fougere, to the podium to bring greetings on behalf of the city.
Thank you, Morgan. Good evening, everyone. On behalf of Regina City Council, I'm very pleased to be here. I believe Council Young may be here with me. I'm not sure. She may be coming later, but I'm very pleased to be here. And you know, it's a great event to be asked to speak at. You know, there are so many great and inspiring stories of women in public life, and I want to focus on that just for a moment. That's the life that I live, who have really shaped our city and our province and, of course, our country. So when I think of these people, I think of people like Ashley Walker. She's the first female councillor elected to Regina in 1932. And a couple of firsts as well for cabinet ministers in the province, Joan Duncan and Pat Smith, back in 1982. And one of my favorites I like to talk a little bit about is Sylvia Fedoruk. And we all know who she is, of course, the first lieutenant governor of Saskatchewan. But more importantly, I mean, that's an important role, of course. But she is, in her own right, a researcher, a doctor, of course, in cancer treatment with Cobalt 16 radiation. So she made a huge impact on not just on public life, but medicine. And I also want to focus, well, in my life again on City Council, on Barbara Young, Dr. Young, former head of the Public School Board, now member of City Council, and Sharon Bryce, a nurse, who, like all people, give their life to public service to make our city better, make our province better, and we're all better for that. But there's only one problem. There isn't enough women on council. There isn't enough women in public life. And, you know, we had an election that happened yesterday, and the Prime Minister-elect said he wants half his cabinet to be women. I think that's a great first step in recognizing the potential and the leadership that women bring to all walks of life. So that's very, very good news. But there are other people in the room, too, and Morgan mentioned them, too. But for me, there are people that I look up to in public life as well. Mayor Higgins, former member of the provincial legislature, cabinet minister, now mayor of Moose Jaw. I work with her a lot through the big city mayor's caucus in Suma. She's a great leader, has shown that provincially, and certainly Moose Jaw has really helped that city move forward, no question about that. Christine Tell, Laura Ross, great public servants. We have so many role models here to look after and look up to, so very pleased to be here to talk about that. But Sheila Fallman, I'm looking forward to hearing your comments, your inspiration, what you have to say, and I'm sure it'll be a great wisdom for all of us to hear tonight. I too thank the organizers for a nice event. Well done, your 12th year. Great impression, good crowd. I like the ratio, I feel very comfortable here tonight. So again, on behalf of Regina City Council, thank you so much for the invitation and enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Worship to stay up on stage with us for a minute, and we'll also invite our very talented pianists to come up with Elizabeth Kellum, Emily Kellum, Alexandra Merrick, Sophia Merrick, and Jonathan Pop. Please come to the stage. Or however many are still here, you come up. We have a, and oh, there we go. We'd like to thank you so much for your wonderful music this evening and for coming out tonight. So I'll give them all a round of applause.